Good morning. I just want to share a quick word with you guys. I am in Ephesians chapter 4, verse 25 through 27. Therefore, each of you must put off falsehood and speak truthfully to your neighbor, for we are all members of one body. In your anger, do not sin. Do not let the sun go down while you are still angry, and do not give the devil a foothold. Now, when I'm reading this, you know, I think about the old life versus our new life with God, Jesus. You know, we have to put off the old ways of thinking, strongholds. Strongholds being fortified places in our mind where we have always done things a certain way. That was our old life. We have to put that off and step into our new life. And then referring to anger, you know, it's normal to get angry. Believe me, I get angry, but we can't sin when we're angry. Recently, I've been having like these dreams where I'm thinking about things that happened in my past, and I'm so upset about it still. And it's just weird because I thought I had gotten past a lot of things, I'd moved forward, I'd forgiven. That's what I thought, but you know, these dreams are just recurring. So over the last month, and I feel like maybe God is telling me there's some things I need to deal with. So it goes on to say, do not give the enemy a foothold. And I feel like when we don't forgive others, that's when we're giving the enemy a foothold. You know, I keep thinking about, you know, these terrible things that happened to me. And I told myself I let it go, but clearly I haven't. So this morning, you know, I said a prayer and I told God, I release these people, this person that hurt me. I forgive them. And if I have to say it a million times for a whole year, that's what I'll do. But I think it's very important not to let the enemy get a foothold in our life at all. So when we're angry about something or someone hurts us, they betray us, we need to deal with it quickly. Don't let that anger fester. Don't let the unforgiveness fester inside of yourself and grow into something so ugly. We need to forgive and move forward. God, you know, even when people betray us, God knows what that feels like to be betrayed. He was betrayed by Judas. Judas walked with him, was close with him, was learning from him, and he betrayed him. And Jesus loved him. So God knows what it's like to feel betrayal. And God, even in these terrible situations where people abandon us and they hurt us, you know, there's still favor there. You look at Joseph. I've mentioned him many times. I love the story of Joseph. Betrayed by his brothers because God had favor on him. His father loved him and favored him. And then betrayed again when he goes into prison and he's lifted out of the prison and he's working for Potiphar and his wife, you know, desires to want to be with him, and he doesn't want to do that. He's not going to do that. And he's betrayed again. He's betrayed again and he's left in prison again. And then Joseph, he interprets dreams. There's what, the baker? He's interpreting the dream for the baker, and he tells him, hey, don't forget about me in here. And he forgets about him. And he's abandoned. Again, he's abandoned. But it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter what these people do. It doesn't matter what happened. God's favor was still on Joseph, and he elevated him anyways. And just like me and you, when people betray us and they hurt us, God still has that favor on us. There is nothing that they can do to stop whatever God has planned for your life. And remember that, but always, 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 you know, forgive others. Don't let the enemy ever get a foothold in your life. I am praying for you. Pray for me. Be blessed. Have a fabulous day.